So the rise in emission expected for this year really is caused by, I mean, almost all countries are contributing to this, either by having a rise in emissions themselves or by decreasing less than expected. China, the biggest emitter, the emissions are projected to rise. That's associated with government stimulus in the construction industry, which emits lots of CO2, possibly, probably, I guess, temporary, although it's difficult to say. In the US, also growth in emissions, and that is associated with a cold winter followed by a hot summer, both of which use a lot of energy. In Europe, less of a decrease in emissions, and that's from emissions in oil, so petrol use in transportation that is increasing, offsetting decreases in coal and gas. And then India and other developing countries, strong rise just simply from development that is not yet decoupled to economic growth. This is, however, we're in a very different situation than we were just like 5 years ago, because there are really very clear trends in the background. Decrease in coal use, very large decrease in the US, very large decrease across Europe, and in China it's not increasing the way it was, although the last 2 years it's been a small rise again. And beside along this, so the coal decrease is displaced by, in the US, gas, but also in recent years, very clearly from growth in renewable. Growth in renewable also displacing coal in Europe. And these are patterns that are observed in every region of the world. Large investment in renewables have driven the cost down, and they are now growing really, really quickly. Still, if we look globally, there's the ups and downs of coals. Oil and gas are growing unabated, oil associated with transport, gas with all kinds of things, industry and heating. And we are not seeing the penetration now in the economy at large of the efforts to go away from emissions that we're seeing in renewable energy. This needs to penetrate to transport, to buildings and industry.